I'm so sorry for everything.
He never mentioned anything about it. He's the best actor in the world.
And we're now hearing from Ricky Sanchez, a musician who played with Castro, a longtime friend, who says he visited the home too many times to count, offering this chilling detail.
When I was about to leave, I tried to open the door, I couldn't even, because there were so many locks in there. I mean, they said, wait a minute, I can't get out of here, would you please help me? They opened it, I got it for you, and then he opened it for me.
He says he was there just last week, and that he met the little girl.
He grabbed me by the hand. He introduced her to me as his granddaughter. She was shy. She don't spoke a word.
As Castro sat in court, his head buried, community wondering what now plays in the mind of a man accused of so much evil. ABC station WEWS reporting on a letter found in his home, remorseful, saying he's a sex addict.
He has no remorse, in my view, for the victims, for his own family. He only has remorse for himself, because people who will do the depraved things that he has done or been alleged to have done for the past 10 years has not one caring or feeling bone in his body about humanity.
His family now ruined by his alleged secrets, as three other families tonight celebrate their daughters smiling again.
They can smile freely now, which is the most beautiful thing in those three that went through, that they can actually smile now.
And they are smiling.
Yes, they are. Every second. Every second. My daughter can't stop smiling.
And neither can mom.
I know. Oh, yes.
I'm David Muir for Nightline in Cleveland. A lot of